Chapter 7 Evolution, Origin of Life. When we look at stars in a clear night sky, we see how they look at the at that exact moment. No, false. The universe is almost dash billion years old. 20 billion years old. Dash theory attempts to explain the origin of the universe. Big Bang theory. The temperature came down as the universe expanded. First gases to be formed were dash and dash. So first gases to be formed were hydrogen and helium. Earth has formed dash years ago, 4.5 billion years ago. Which four gases covered the early Earth's surface? H2O, CH4, CO2 and NH3. Which is water, methane, carbon dioxide and ammonia. Dash rays from the sun broke up water into H2 and O2, UV rays. Life appeared dash years ago, 4 billion years ago. Early Latin or Greek thinkers thought units of life called dash. This idea was named dash. So early Greek thinkers thought units of life called spores. This idea was named panspermia. No one believes in panspermia today. No, false. Still, it is a favorite idea for some astronomers. What was the theory of spontaneous regeneration? Life came out of decaying and rotting matter like straw and mud, etc. Dash demonstrated that life comes only from pre-existing life. Louis Pasteur. Dash dismissed spontaneous generation theory. Louis Pasteur. Dash and Dash proposed that first form of life could have come from non-living organic molecules. Oparin and Haldane. Oparin country was Dash and Haldane country was Dash. Oparin was from Russia and Haldane was from England. Earlier conditions on Earth were reducing or oxidizing and high or low temperature. So early conditions are reducing and high temperature. A diagrammatic representation of Miller's experiment is shown in diagram 1, label A to K, and name the gases P, Q, R and S. So here is the diagram 1, and here A is the electrodes, B is spark discharge, C is water out, D is condenser, E is water in, F is water droplets, G is water containing organic compounds, H is liquid water in trap, I is boiling water, J is to vacuum pump, K is gases, P is CH4, methane, Q is H2, hydrogen, R is NH3, ammonia, S is H2O, water. Miller was an American, English or Russian scientist. So Miller was an American scientist. The four gases Miller used in his experiments were methane, hydrogen, ammonia and H2O, water. In year dash, Miller created electric discharge at temperature dash. So in year 1953, Miller created electric discharge at temperature 800 degrees Celsius. He observed formation of fats, sugar, amino acids. So he observed the formation of amino acids. Analysis of meteorites revealed similar compounds indicating that similar processes are occurring elsewhere in space. Yes, true. First non-cellular forms of life originated dash billion years ago, 3 billion years ago. Non-cellular form of life mean the giant molecules like RNA, protein, polysaccharide. The first cellular form of life did not possibly originate till about dash billion years ago, 2 billion years ago. According to religious beliefs, the earth is about dash years old, 4,000 years old, which is not possible. Charles Darwin's ship name was HMS Beagle. Any population has built-in variation in characteristics. Yes, true. At which level of grouping does evolution occur? Population. The fitness according to Darwin ultimately and only refers to dash fitness, reproductive fitness. Dash, a naturalist, worked in dash, came to similar conclusions as Darwin. So Alfred Wallace, who worked in Malay Archipelago, came to similar conclusions as Darwin. The geological history of Earth closely correlates with the biological history of Earth. Yes, true. A study of fossils in different igneous layers indicates the geological period in which they existed. No, false. The sedimentary layers. Not the igneous layers. What is paleontological evidence? evidence due to fossils. Embryological support for evolution was proposed by Ernest Haeckel. Embryos of all vertebrates, including humans, develop a row of vestigial gill slit just behind the head. Yes, true. This theory was rejected on careful observation by Carl Ernest von Baer. An example of homologous organs is shown in diagram 2. Identify the plant species A and B and the modified structure X and Y. So here in diagram 2, A is bougainvillea and B is cucurbita. Now in A, X is thorn and in B, Y is tendril. Ernest Baer noted that embryos pass through the adult stage of primitive animals. No, false. Example of divergent evolution is whales, bats, cheetah and human in the pattern of bones of forelimbs. Second example is vertebrate hearts or brains. And third example is thorn and tendrils of bougainvillea and cucurbita. Example of convergent evolution. So examples of convergent evolution are wings of butterfly and of birds. Second example is eyes of octopus and that of mammals. And third is flippers of penguins and dolphins. Fourth example is sweet potato, which is a root modification, and potato, which is a stem modification. Analogous structures are a result of convergent evolution. Yes, true. Homology indicates common ancestry. Yes, true. No variant is completely wiped out. Yes, true. Before industrialization, more white or dark winged moths were on trees. So more white winged moths were on trees. Due to absence of lichens, dash winged moths survived. Dark winged moths survived. Dark winged moths were also called dash moths, melanized moths. Lichens are used as an industrial pollution indicator. Yes, true. Evolution is not a direct process. Instead, it is a dash process. It is a stochastic process. Triceratops evolved from Stegosaurus or Brachiosaurus. So, Triceratops evolved from Stegosaurus. This is present in NCRT diagram and this is very important. Brachiosaurus gave rise to dash. Brachiosaurus gave rise to Tyrannosaurus. Archaeopteryx gave rise to dash and dash, to Crocodilin and Pterodon. Darwin went to Dash Island, Galapagos Island. Darwin finches were black or brown? They were black. Original varieties of Darwin finches were dash-eating or seed-eating. Some Darwin finches were insectivorous and vegetarian finches. Yes, true. Evolution of different species in a given geographical area, starting from a point and literally radiating to other areas of geography, habitats, is called adaptive radiation. Adaptive radiation of marsupials of Australia is shown in diagram 3. Name all the species A to J. So here is the diagram 3. Here A is Tasmanian wolf, B is tiger cat, C is banded anteater, D is marsupial rat, E is kangaroo, F is wombat, G is bandicoot, H is koala, I is marsupial mole, and J is sugar glider. All Australian marsupials evolved within Australian island continent. Yes, true. When more than one adaptive radiation appear to have occurred in an isolated geographical area representing different habitats, one can call this convergent evolution. Convergent evolution of placental mammals X and Australian marsupials Y is shown in diagram 4. Identify all the species A to N. So here is the diagram 4, and here X is the placental mammals and Y are the Australian marsupials. And here A is mole and B is marsupial mole. Then C is anteater and D is numbat. Then E is mouse and F is marsupial mouse. G is lemur, H is spotted cuscus. I is flying squirrel, J is flying phalanger. K is bobcat, L is Tasmanian tiger cat. M is wolf and N is Tasmanian wolf. Lemur is similar to spotted cuscus. Bobcat is similar to Tasmanian tiger cat. Numbat is similar to anteater. Flying squirrel is similar to flying phalanger. Flying phalanger is a placental mammal or Australian marsupial. So flying phalanger is an Australian marsupial. Biological evolution. Evolution by natural selection in a true sense would have started when when cellular forms of life with differences in metabolic capability originated on Earth. The rate of appearance of new forms is linked to life cycle or lifespan. Darwinian fitness is based on inherited or acquired characters. Darwinian fitness is based on inherited characters. Adaptive ability is not inherited. No, false. The two key concepts of Darwinian theory of evolution are branching descent and natural selection. Lamarck was a Greek, Latin, French biologist, physicist, or naturalist. So Lamarck was a French naturalist. Lamarck gave example of giraffes. Problem with Lamarck theory was it said that acquired characters are passed to the next generation, which is wrong. When we describe the story of the world, we describe evolution as a process or result of processes. When we describe the story of dash, we treat evolution as a consequence of a process called dash. So when we describe the story of life on Earth, we treat evolution as a consequence of a process called the natural selection. Work of Dash on population may have influenced Darwin. Work of Thomas Malthus. Dash's work on Dash brought the idea of mutation. Hugo G. Rice's work on evening primrose, which is Oenothera lamarckiana, brought the idea of mutation. Darwin variations were small or large and directional or directionless, while that of Dash was small or large and directional or directionless. So Darwinian variations were small and directional, while the mutations, while that of Hugo D. Vries were large and they were directionless. D. Vries believed mutation caused Dash and hence it called Dash. D. Vries believed mutation caused speciation and hence called it saltation. If gene migration happens multiple times, it is called gene flow. Sum total of all the allelic frequencies is 1. Frequency of AA in a population is PQ. False, it is 2PQ. If the frequency of heterozygotes in a population is 0.5, what will be the value of P and Q? So by taking 2PQ equal to 0.5 and applying the equation P plus Q is equal to 1 and the equation P square plus 2PQ plus Q square is equal to 1, we get P equal to 0.5 and Q equal to 0.5. Five factors that affect Hardy-Winger equilibrium are gene migration or gene flow, genetic drift, mutation, genetic recombination, and natural selection. What is genetic drift? Variation in the relative frequency of different genotypes in a small population owing to the chance disappearance of particular genes as individuals die or do not reproduce. Genetic drift operates in a small or large isolated population. In a small isolated population, which two effects are seen through the genetic drift? Bottleneck effect and founder effect. What is founder effect? What leads to founder effect? It is the loss of genetic variation that occurs when a new population is established by a very small number of individuals from a large population. Genetic drift leads to founder effect. Natural selection, where more individuals acquire specific character value other than the mean character value, leads to directional selection. Natural selection, when more individuals acquire mean character value, it is called stabilization. And natural selection, when more individuals acquire dash characters value, is called disruptive curve, peripheral characters. Tell the graph of stabilization, directional and disruptive changes. So the graph in which the peak gets higher and narrower, it is for stabilization. In the graph in which this peak shifts in one direction, it is directional. And in which there are two peaks formed, it is disruptive. You can check out in the answer key. A brief account of evolution. First cellular form of life arose dash million years ago, 2000 million years ago. Around dash million years ago, invertebrates were formed and active around 500 million years ago. Name the three categories in which the geological time is divided. Arrange them rank-wise from highest to lowest. Era, then period, and then epoch. This is out of NCRT. Jawless fishes evolved around dash million years ago, 350 million years ago. Seaweeds and few plants existed probably dash million years ago, 320 million years ago. First organisms that invaded land were plants. Fish with dash and dash could move on land and go back to water. Fish with stout and strong fins. Fishes invaded land dash million years ago. 350 million years ago. In dash year, dash fish was caught in country dash, which was thought to be extinct. So in 1938, coelacanth fish was caught in the country South Africa, which was thought to be extinct. Coelacanth was a lobifin. Dash evolved into first amphibians, lobifins. Lobifins were ancestors of modern day dash and dash, frogs and salamanders. Amphibians evolved into reptiles. Yes, true. One reproductive advantage of reptiles over amphibians is reptiles lay thick-shelled eggs which do not dry up in the sun, unlike those of amphibians. Giant ferns fell to form coal deposits. Reptiles which went back to become fish-like reptiles were dash probably dash million years ago, were ichthyosaurus probably 200 million years ago. The biggest reptile was dash with dash feet height. So the biggest reptile was Tyrannosaurus rex with 20 feet height. About dash million years ago, the dinosaur suddenly disappeared from the earth about 65 million years ago. Small sized reptiles of dinosaur era still exist today. Yes, true. The first mammals were like shrews. Due to continental drift, North America fauna was overridden by South America fauna. No, false. South America fauna overridden by North American fauna. Example of mammals who live in water are whales, dolphins, seals, and sea cows. Terms like Triassic, Jurassic are epoch, era, or period. So terms like Triassic, Jurassic are period. Name the three recent eras from new to old. Cenozoic, Mesozoic, and Paleozoic. Name the different periods of the respective eras from new to old. Periods of eras are Cenozoic. In Cenozoic, Quaternary to Tertiary. In Mesozoic, Cretaceous, then Jurassic, then Triassic. Third is Paleozoic. In this, there is Permian, then Carboniferous, then Devonian, then Silurian. Mammals evolved from sauropsids or synapsids? From synapsids. Birds evolved from sauropsids or synapsids? From sauropsids. The ancestors of mammals of Permian and Jurassic periods are Pelycosaurus for Permian, and in Jurassic period, it is therapsids. Thecodonts gave rise to crocodiles, birds, and dinosaurs. Sauropsids give rise to modern day reptiles and birds. Thecodont was dash period, Permian period. Chlorophyte ancestors give rise to trachophyte ancestors and bryophyte. Dash diverged from trachophyte and Silurian period, Zosterophyllum. Dash and dash originated from Zosterophyllum, arborescent and herbaceous lycopods. Dash are the oldest living vascular land plants, lycopods. Arborescent lycopods became extinct by the end of Paleozoic era. Dash gave rise to Xylophyton, Rhynia type plant. Classes of Pteridophyta are Coelopsida, Lycopsida, Sphenopsida, and Pteropsida. Classes of Gymnosperms are Cycadophyta, Gingkophyta, Nitophyta, and Coniferophyta. Xylophyton gave rise to Sphenopsida, Pteropsida, Gingkophyta, Nitophyta, Coniferophyta, Progymnosperms. Seed ferns gave rise to Cycadophyta and Angiosperms. Origin and evolution of man. About dash million year ago, Rheopithecus and Ramapithecus were existing 15 million year ago. Ramapithecus was more ape-like, while Rheopithecus was more man-like. No, false. Ramapithecus was man-like and Rheopithecus was ape-like. Few fossils of man-like bones have been discovered in dash and dash in Ethiopia and Tanzania. About dash million years ago, man-like primates walked in East Africa. about 3 to 4 million years ago. They were probably not taller than Dash feet, 4 feet. They walked upright. Yes, true. Dash million years ago, Australopithecus probably lived in Dash. 2 million years ago, Australopithecus probably lived in Eastern Africa grassland. Australopithecus hunted with stone weapons and essentially ate meat. No, false, essentially ate fruit. Human-like beings are called hominids. First hominid was Homo habilis. Homo habilis probably did not eat meat. Yes, true. Fossils discovered in Dash in year Dash revealed the next stage, i.e. So fossil discovered in Java in the year 1981 revealed the next stage, i.e. Homo erectus. Homo erectus existed Dash million years ago, 1.5 million years ago. Dash and Dash were hairy and walked like gorillas and chimpanzees. Dryopithecus and Ramapithecus were hairy and walked like gorillas and chimpanzees. Homo erectus did not eat meat. False, they ate meat. Neanderthal man lived near Dash and Dash between Dash and Dash years back. Lived near East and Central Asia between 1 lakh to 40,000 years back. Dash first time used hide to protect their body and buried their dead. Neanderthal man. Cranial capacity of Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Neanderthal man are. So for Homo habilis it is 650 to 800 cc. For Homo erectus it was 900 cc. And Neanderthal man it was 1400 cc. Homo sapiens arose in Africa. Ice age occurred between Dash to Dash years ago, 75,000 to 10,000 years ago. Prehistoric cave art developed about Dash years ago, 18,000 years ago. One such cave painting by prehistoric humans can be seen at Dash in Dash district of Madhya Pradesh at Bimpetka Rock Shelter in Raisin district of Madhya Pradesh. Agriculture came around Dash years back, 10,000 years back. Tell the name of all the stages of human evolution given in NCERT. So all the stages were Dryopithecus, Dimapithecus, Australopithecus, Homo habilis, Homo erectus, Neanderthal man and Homo sapiens. Chapter complete. Thank you.